Hey guys, it's Frozen Joe, and I'm here to do another episode of the 2016 Backyard Fruit Tree Project. I'm here to talk about a fig tree today that's producing its Breba crop. Guys, I'm here to talk about Desert King. I have two Desert King trees. These are figs from one of them. These are figs from another. This is from the younger tree. This is from the more mature, larger tree. And I wanted to show you guys this too. I use these baggies, these organza baggies, to protect the figs. And I have these starlings that have been coming around this year. And what they've been doing is, when the fig sits inside the bag, if you can imagine, they're reaching their beak down through the, they're like opening the bag up with their beak and reaching down, kind of eating the figs from the inside out like that. And they've been ruining a lot of figs for me so far this year. So this one, buddy, come here, buddy. Come here, this one. Buddy likes figs, so he can have that one. Before we open up these fruits, let me just show you the trees. This here is my younger tree. And this is something new I have. I just put this in this weekend. And got some little chicks. I don't know if you can see them. There's some chicks back in there. Seems like the camera wants to just focus on that mesh. There's some chicks back in there. Dogs are excited. But anyway, this is my Desert King tree. This is one of them. It's almost ready. These are what the leaves look like on this one. Pretty large, some of them. A lot of them are smaller. This tree is just a few years old. And I haven't pruned it or done anything to it, but you see it just wants to grow straight up. It makes it a little bit challenging because the fruit is quite high on this, but you know, I'm letting my trees grow taller, so let me just see what this one does. I have to use a ladder to harvest the fruit. And this is my other one. My other Desert King tree is this one here. This is an older tree. Planted this one here in 2011. It has a lot of figs on it. This one here is feeling pretty good too. I'll take that one also. See the leaves, they're similar. I guess it's pretty typical. This produces a lot of Brebas. I've been eating quite a few. My family, we've been enjoying this. The Breba is forming on it. And I don't know if you can see, but I've had a lot of damage from the birds this year. Like that. I mean, they just have messed up a lot of these figs. You know, you go, you see a fig, you think it's ready. See this? They work the bags open. They work the opening of the bag up, and then they peck into there at the figs. It starts to get close to being ripe, and they ruin a lot of figs. You know, you think that there's a fig ready. It feels soft to the touch, and you touch it, and it's all been chewed out inside and messed up. It sucks. I still get a good number of them. Without the bags, I mean, I think all the ripe ones, all the ones that are ripening would be ruined. With the bags, at least I still get some of them. And there's certain trees the birds seem to really like. Desert King is one of them, Violet de Bordeaux. This Havasu they like a lot too. The figs that seem to be larger or just more visible on the tree are the ones they seem to really go after. This one out of the bag. So you can see, you know, the larger, more mature tree is producing larger fruit. The other tree will catch up as it gets bigger. And it'll produce more. This tree is, that more mature tree is producing more figs as well. More, and they're larger. This one will catch up. These are actually a little bit more ripe though, because the birds have been concentrating on this tree. They haven't been messing with this one too much, so these have been getting more ripe. Let me cut some of these open. You can see this one has a closed eye on it for the most part. And this one has a little bit of an opening to it. I don't have a problem with these figs rotting at all, getting that mold in them. It's not been a problem at all with Desert King. So this is the most ripe of the figs. And one of the things that's tough with figs is just to let them sit on the tree long enough to get really, really ripe. And one of those damn starlings is in my tree right now. I can't stand those birds. Hey, hey, get out of there. Man, those starlings. All right, so let's take a look at what these look like inside. You can see they're a green fig. They get kind of a yellowish hue to them here as they ripen. This one is like dead ripe. See how pretty that is. And I've seen these in different climates, like the Pacific Northwest. This is a real popular fig. And up there, I notice a lot of times, you know, they'll be very red on the interior when they ripen. But for me, in my climate, they tend to be more of this color as they ripen here in this climate and soil. This is a good fig. I look forward to this fig every year. You can see, especially from the more mature tree, they're pretty good-sized figs. And they have nice flavor, especially for a green fig. Let me taste this. Wow. This has a lot of flavor to it. Very nice. Try this one. First of all, texturally, these figs are very soft. Very, very soft. Very, you know, nice flavor, good sweetness. And one of the things I appreciate about this fig, I think one of the things that makes figs special as a fruit, they have this characteristic that, you know, I've heard described as richness. There's a richness to their flavor profile. And some figs have it, some varieties tend to have that richness more than others. And what I mean by richness is, there's like a syrupiness to them that coats the inside of your mouth when you eat them, and the flavor just lingers on your palate for a long time. It's like another element of flavor to them. You know, it's not just the sweetness, it's not just the flavor of fig or of different fruit profiles that people pick out in certain figs, but there's a richness, almost like a creaminess that just lingers on your palate for a long time when you eat a good fig. Some varieties have that more than others. And Desert King has that. It has good richness to it. It's a good, rich flavor profile to it. Sweet. You know, the flavor itself is a little bit mild. It's not like, not like a big, complex kind of flavor profile to it, but just very pleasant. Good sweetness, good richness. Pleasant, soft, nice, big fig. And it produces a large breba crop. Most fig varieties, they'll give you, you know, just a few brebas and put their energy into the main crop, whereas Desert King is unique because it does the opposite, really. It gives you a big breba crop up front at the beginning of the year, and then the main crop, you really don't get a main crop from it. It's just the breba crop. And you know, the difference, if you don't know, the difference between a breba fig and a main crop fig is that the breba grows on the previous year's wood that was produced in the previous year of growth, and the main crop grows on the current year's growth of wood. So breba, you know, they come earlier in the year. I mean, here we are, it's May, it's mid-May, and, you know, for a week or so already, I've been getting a lot of figs off of the Desert Kings. So they give you a good crop early in the season. And the figs are large and tasty and good. And, you know, if you're only gonna have one fig, you don't wanna get Desert King, because you want something with the main crop. It's going to give you a longer harvest season, you know, for most of the country, for most people's situation. But If you've already got a few main crop varieties going, I think it's a good idea to add a Desert King because it just extends that harvest season forward earlier into the year, and they're delicious figs. You know, I really enjoy them. That's Desert King. That's what the fruit looks like. I have two Desert King trees, and I'm glad I have them. What's nice is by the time their crops kind of peters out, their breba crop is finishing, well, that's usually when the main crop starts on most of the other trees. So it's good, the timing is good. Gives you more figs for other times of the year, earlier in the year. It's a good tree, I like it, and you get a chance to plant one, I don't think you'll be disappointed. Guys, it's Desert King. It's a good fig. Thanks for watching.